We take a look out of our magic window, wait to hear our magic John Coleman predicting more snow. We hear that the city is now preparing a new law to iron out a catch-22 in Illinois' snow shoveling law. The way it's worded now, if you shovel your sidewalk, you're liable for a lawsuit if someone slips and falls. If you don't shovel, it's considered an act of God. Mayor Belanek wants to change that around to relieve Chicagoans of the personal liability if they go to all that trouble to shovel their walk. It's just a proposal at this point, so stay tuned. John, before the season started, I heard climatologists say that it was very unlikely that we could have three bad winters in a row.
Just proves they don't know a whole lot about anything, doesn't it, Terry?
Comes in threes, perhaps, too.
Do you remember my outlook for the winter?
No.
Frequent vicious storms and yo-yo temperatures.
But
we could use a little of that up on the yo-yo.
Periods of mild temperature. Yes.
Well, wait till next week. And it was wait till tomorrow as the computer really led us astray. Remember last night when I was predicting this big old snow to get going tonight? Well, the computer giveth, and then the computer in its next run taketh away. That's not me speaking. That was Steve Kahn, the forecaster on duty at the National Weather Service last night, and I think he called it. Very philosophic man. Now, tonight, the computer says, hey, bingo, this is it. Maybe this storm didn't happen, but a goodly to big snow seems destined to hit Chicago tomorrow night and Friday morning. And I think I'll go along with the computer again. Maybe one more time I'll be caught in a spool of data tape, but these satellite pictures seem to support it. The storm that didn't get here today is doing it in Kansas and Oklahoma as we sequence the satellite pictures. But in the west, a storm is brewing that will be coming through Iowa and Wisconsin and western Illinois by tomorrow morning and approaching the Chicago area by tomorrow afternoon and then over us. For the moment, a lobe of Arctic high pressure centered over Iowa continues to dominate. This is a perfect night for cooling, and our sub-zero record is absolutely assured. And in its wake, the storm that's produced 3 to 7 inches of snow in Idaho and continued the terrible ice storm at Portland, Oregon, is zeroing in on us. Chicago got up to 3 officially today, while the temperature climbed to 77 down at Isle Mirada, one of my favorite key spots. -4 at Midway Airport. With Fahey gone, I can say it right once. 2 above on the lakefront. Everybody head for the lakefront. We bunch up there and warm up. 10 below at Waukegan. A west breeze at 7 miles per hour. The humidity 67%, the barometer going up, the wind chill 17 below, and the thermometer has not had its goodly workout. Tonight, cold. Well, that's putting it mildly. 5 below in the city, 13 below in the boonies, and into the record book on light northwest breezes and clear skies. By tomorrow dawn, the wind will be around to the southwest. And tomorrow, I'm predicting we get all the way up to 8 as clouds replace the sun by midday at latest. And by tomorrow night, snow will be piling up on top of the ice here in the city. That snow should be the heaviest tomorrow night and Friday morning, tapering off Friday afternoon, and there's no reason we shouldn't get several inches, and there's some reason to think that we still have a chance of another really significant snowstorm before the week's over. The weekend Saturday cold, but please note, Saturday I predict will stay above the zero mark, maybe even during the snow tomorrow night. The reason is out in the Pacific, as seen on the western satellite. A strong storm system is entrenching in the Gulf of Alaska. The big mother lobe of cold air that has been feeding us is retreating into Siberia. And so I say there is light, that is a warm-up at the end of this bitter tunnel of Arctic cold. And by next week, right on, it'll be warm enough to go play in all the new snow we'll have, Tim. I assume you'll be doing skiing features next week.
John, I'll do you whatever you tell me to do. I'll do
it. Oh, really? But go jump in the lake.
Thank you. And let's keep Artis Gilmore out of the cold. He's nursing a flu, and it was feared because of that flu he wouldn't play tonight, John. And it was also feared Artis would break his string of playing in 624 straight games, but it takes more than the flu to sideline Artis. Not only did he play in his 625th straight game, he scored 29 points. The Bulls beat New Jersey 120-116. Before we show you some of the game, Weigel's Wild World of Sports shows you a little frantic table tennis action at midcourt. Look at the beautiful get right
here, and he winds up winning the point. Hull ride, and the Bulls wind up winning the game. Because of Artis's 29 points, he gets two right there. John Mengelt had 24, and you want to know why they call him Crash? Right into the scorer's table there, but he's not through yet. Watch Crash at the other end. He scores, goes right into the Nets bench. One more time, Crash, hit the floor. There he goes. Kevin Lockery, the Nets coach, he thinks that's hilarious. Plays Gene Krupa on the water cooler there. But, hey, listen, the Nets are tough. They come back, but Artis stuffs it in. It's 114-110 now with a score. 114 all. The clutch basket by Mengel, and the Bulls win it 120-116. In other scores, Boston loses its fifth in a row. Milwaukee-Atlanta still in double overtime. Detroit beats our Loyola Ramblers. Alabama hands LSU its first loss of the season, and the Hustle win up at DePaul. In hockey tonight, the Blackhawks go for three wins in a row against L.A., and not only do they get that win, but Tony Esposito gets his first shutout of the season. Elsewhere, Montreal is upset by Pittsburgh, and the Islanders and Detroit tie. The Islanders still have the best record in hockey. In other news, Earl Bruce of Iowa State is going to be the man to succeed Woody Hayes as football coach at Ohio State. Down in Miami, Ford Super Bowl tickets are being sold on the street for $200 apiece already. Super Sunday is going to be a mess when the people with those phony tickets show up expecting to get into the game. And even Joel Daly showed up today to help Papa Bear George Halas celebrate his 84th birthday. Now, Papa Bear's birthday officially doesn't come until February the 2nd, but he's going to be out of town then, so Hugh Hill helped organize a party for Papa Bear. He got a kiss, but he wants the biggest present of all, a Super Bowl, and he told Bill Frink when he's going to get that present.
Well, I think at least a couple of years, no less than that. We'll be improved next year and again the following year, and it should be then the third year, Bill.
Well, there you have it. So what's three more years between friends, right? Hey, while we wait for that three more year Super Bowl, let's get into this week's Blooper Bowl. Fractured football featuring those wild and crazy guys of the NFL, starting with the Houston Oilers, Dan Pastorini, to Tim Wilson, to Mike Barber, back to Mike Barber. And there he goes, folks. Hey, hey. Now watch this punt by Glenn Walker of the Rams. Whoops. He doesn't get it off, but look what happens to the ball. This is a very talented ball. Spinning on the turf. It's tough to kick a ball when it's spinning like that, so kick something that doesn't move. Tony Hill kicks the marker right there. Ah, but those guys have fun. Lynn Swann and John Stallworth, those are crazy guys from Pittsburgh. They have a good time, right? Hey, they just score. Oh, look at there. He's down the road in Los Angeles. What do football players do when they get happy? Well, just about anything, Joel. Ah, we have fun, don't we?
I can tell you what you were watching earlier tonight.
I was watching those crazy Bulls beat the New Jersey Knicks.
Oh, tell me.
Thanks, Tim. In Cambodia tonight, the Vietnamese army is mopping up what's left of the vanquished Khmer Rouge government. The deposed rulers are said to have shaky control of the remaining 20% of Cambodia. The Soviet Union has already recognized the Vietnamese-backed government, now in control of Phnom Penh. The new prime minister of Iran, Shapur Bakhtiar, says there is a danger of a military takeover, but that he still expects the Shah to leave the country. Bakhtiar said he would do what he could to prevent a military coup. A fire at Ottawa Community Hospital, southwest of Joliet, forced 70 patients to be transferred by ambulance to nearby hospitals. The blaze broke out in the four-year-old building's electric generator room and was reportedly confined to that area. No injuries are reported. In a moment, some news that just doesn't seem to fit any place else. Stay with us.
You know why Roman meal bakers like their work? They like the smell when all that bread's in the oven. And they like the idea that they're baking something special. But there's more to Roman meal than good baking. It's what Roman meal's made with. A unique blend of select grains, enriched flour, honey, ingredients that make a delicious light brown bread with natural whole grain goodness. I like that. And this Roman meal bakery thought you'd like to know.
Hello, Rusty Jones. Hi, I'm Rusty Jones. And you know what? I'm the one new car option you can buy that'll appreciate in value. That's right, because I'll stay with your new car as long as you own it. Winter and summer, day and night, not even a coffee break. working to save your car from rust. And a rust-free car is worth more. So at New Car Time, insist on Rusty Jones Rust Proof.
Hello, Rusty Jones. Goodbye, Rusty Cars.
Excuse me, sir. I'm extremely thirsty. You wouldn't happen to have any Stroh's beer, would you?
No, but I got some nice cold water.
No. I really had a taste for some Stroh's.
There goes a real beer lover.
Say, rolling writer.
Rolling writer.
No. Smooth, flowing, like the rolling writer Pentel pen. Try it. Note, the steel ball rests in a cushion. It's not just writing, it's rolling.
Ah, rolling writer Pentel pen.
I think he's got it.
Rolling writer!
Pentel pen.